I didn't actually know that the council offered stuff like this.
Obviously the council were heavily involved in that.
What's the first thing they do? They call their local council.
The closer you are, the more we care.
The city of Salisbury is a big council north of the Adelaide CBD. Its 130,000 residents live in a busy and very multicultural area. For younger people in the area though, Saturday nights can be a bit quiet. Now, thanks to the city of Salisbury and a whole bunch of volunteers, there's a safe, healthy option.
Midnight Basketball is a social inclusion tournament for young kids aged 12 to 18 years. Over the course of the tournament, we get the opportunity to provide the kids with a free feed every week. They play tournament basketball and we also provide them with some life skill workshops.
I love working with youth. I wanted to work with youth as another side step to sport and rec management degree. Tonight we've got a downtown activity, so Central District Football Club's coming out and they'll be doing some Oz Kick. I went to Northern Suburbs High School and I've always grown up in the area, so I feel like I can relate to the kids that come to our program, and it's a fantastic opportunity to give them something to join us Saturday night, and I enjoy coming out.
Probationary Constable Rhys Atwood hasn't been out on the beat very long, but he's convinced that a police presence is mutually beneficial.
We all meet up here and they can just have competitive basketball with each other. We give them meals each night, either from us or other council groups. And it's just a good way to break down the boundaries between the youth, volunteers and police.
The program is also heavily reliant on volunteers.
I wanted to volunteer. I've got two small kids. I don't have the time anymore to do it during the week. So Saturday night's perfect for me. They're all so different. Some of them are basketballers, some of them are not. Some are just bored and want something to do. Yeah, they're just goofy teenage kids.
The players enjoy the night.
Well, I come here to play basketball and to have fun, I guess, and to practice my skills. We do workshops and they teach you all about drugs, driving and driving safely and stuff, and what pathways you should choose.
In the life skills workshop, facilitator Jess Law is promoting the virtue of healthy eating, but using a very different approach.
The workshop facilitator is part of the kids' downtime when they're not on the court. Often with young people, I find that messages around if you eat bad food, you're going to get diabetes and you'll be overweight and things like that don't necessarily stick as well because they are young and that's something that will happen a long time in the future. But what I was trying to do tonight was look at more of the financial situation that can occur by choosing healthy options compared to unhealthy options. It's something that the Salisbury Council does pride themselves on, that we do have a lot of healthy initiatives that are going on, and we are very much supported by our council in that arena, which is really great.
It's the end of a busy night, and as the weary basketballers board the SAPOL bus to be delivered safely home,
seatbelt on, please.
Paul Zimney reflects on the program.
What the kids get out of it has been absolutely brilliant. Seeing the young kids grow and develop and get involved in other aspects of the community, there's a number of things these kids have achieved and it's absolutely fantastic.
For career opportunities with your local council, visit careersincouncil.sa.gov.au. Councils get close to the things that matter to you.